podcast that covers important events,
reminders,
and fun stories related to
Freedom Elementary.
Sit back,
relax,
and enjoy the show.
Think of last time we had a Tiger Tube episode.
It had to have been last May, right? I guess that doesn't matter. We're here now.
I've been waiting since kindergarten for this day. Only fifth graders can host Tiger Tube episodes. This is my day to shine.
Is that why you're so dressed up today?
Oh, this old thing? Oh, this is something I just threw on. I was in such a rush to get to a Tiger Tube set today.
Well, since you are so dressed up, would you like to do the honors of revealing One Book, One School book title this year?
Funny you should ask. I have this envelope right here. Drum roll, please. And the book we'll be reading is... Apologies. My producer informed me that we are not at liberty to discuss our book title quite yet. We'll be looking out for a big reveal on October 29th.
Don't you just love this time of the season?
Football season?
No, fall. The leaves are changing color and falling the crisp morning air. Pumpkin spice lattes and ciders and apple picking to my heart's desire.
To each their own, Amelia. I'm a summer guy, catching a tan and playing Minecraft by the beach.
Do you know who else enjoys nature? The one and only Bob Ross. Let's see if he can paint us a happy little fall scene.
Hi, I'm Bob Ross. I'm here to teach you how to make a nice, beautiful fall scene. Okay, and what you're first gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna take a little bit of a red, and a little bit of yellow. Kind of mix it up to make this orangey a little bit. And then you're gonna wanna swipe it to make this beautiful sunset. Mix some water with black and mix it with your brown to make all those arms and tree limbs to hold up all those leaves that you have on there. Okay, now we'll load up a little red and add a little red here. Now we're gonna add some sap green. Jack Frost hasn't hit him yet, but he'll get him soon, that sneaky rascal boy. I mixed up a nice shade of dark brown so I can make bushes and trees closer to the front. I'm making them kind of like in points. So it looks more like trees, maybe some bushes down here. So now we're going to create the illusion of water. So we're going to streak the brush straight down after you dip it in a little bit of water. Now don't you worry about making mistakes in our world. We don't make mistakes, we make happy accidents. Okay, now remember, folks, pay attention to the world around you. The world is beautiful.
That indeed was a happy little fall scene. Thank you, Bob, for sharing your talent with our viewers today.
Yeah.
Whoa, what is that unbelievably loud sound? Where is it coming from?
Oh, that sound? That's just Mr. Moo's voice coming from the library.
Do we even want to know what he's doing in there?
Let's book it to the library to read up what's going on.
Welcome to Genre Jeopardy! I am your host, the media specialist, Mr. Muth. We have three lovely contestants today. We have Brenna, Selick, and Harper. Our categories today are setting, characters, authors, what's it for, and tip-off! Selick, since you're the only boy here, you're the odd one out, you get to go first.
Characters?
For how much?
200.
For 200. This type of genre often has princes or princesses or magical creatures. Selick.
Fairy tale.
Ooh, yes, fairy tales is right. There we go. Selick, 200. Selick, the board is yours. You get to go again.
Setting 100.
Setting for 100. Girls, you can chime in too if you want to. This setting is in the past. Selick.
Historical fiction.
Bingo! Selick, the board is yours.
Characters 100.
Characters for 100. In this genre, animals talk and act like people. Selick again.
Fiction.
Ah, we were looking for a fantasy. Sorry, Selick, I'm gonna take points away. Harper, board is yours.
Characters.
Characters for 300, all right. Characters do impossible things that could not really happen in real life. For example, fly around. Yes, Harper.
Fantasy.
Fantasy! Harper, the board is yours. What would you like?
Characters 400.
Characters 400. And this genre contains stories about a true national hero from the past. Yes, Harper?
Historical fiction.
Historical fiction? Informational. Gotta take points away. Oh, no. All right. Brenna, last one. Let's pick one from a category that we haven't chosen yet.
Authors 100.
This genre has many authors passed down from generation to generation verbally. Looking for traditional literature or folktale. All right, we are down to the last question of the day. We're gonna go to tip off for 500. This genre might include stories about aliens and UFOs or traveling through outer space. Selick?
Fiction.
What kind of fiction? Science fiction. Oh man. Well, I gotta take points away from everybody there. Looks like I'm the big winner, folks. That's our first installment of Genre Jeopardy. Make sure you study up on your genre so you can be a contestant next Tiger Tube.
That Mr. Move is so entertaining and so informative.
You know who else has a wealth of knowledge? Mr. Rodert. Aside from his ACES classes, he's also doing some demonstrations over his lunch period.
That sounds awesome. I wish I could join one.
You can. I think he's doing a demonstration right now on how to carve a pumpkin. Go check it out.
Hi,
My name is Brody. I'm going to show you how to carve a pumpkin.
So what supplies do you need? What things do you need to carve a pumpkin? You need...
paper.
Paper? What else?
That's all.
Oh, but this is going to be a real pumpkin.
A real pumpkin?
A real pumpkin, not one on paper. So if I had a pumpkin right here, what do you need to carve it? I need what?
Scissors.
Scissors. What are you going to do with the scissors?
Cut.
You're going to cut the pumpkin with the scissors?
Yeah, but guess what?
What?
I got this many scissors.
Ten?
At my house.
10 scissors?
Yeah, at my house.
Oh, okay. But if you want to carve a pumpkin, would a scissors work?
Huh?
Would a scissors work to carve a pumpkin?
Yeah, guess what?
What?
You can't put your finger in there.
Oh, that's right, because it's sharp?
Yeah. Do watch this. That's how we carve a pumpkin.
I'm so glad I got to host the Back to School Fall Special for TigerTube.
Me too. Time to hang out my suit and tie until my next big performance.
You can switch out your suit and tie for some Tiger wear. The Harrisburg Tiger football team plays Sioux Falls Jefferson tonight at home. And the volleyball team takes on Sioux Falls Christian next Tuesday.
Let's see if I can get round up a few of my friends to get pumped for the Harrisburg games that are coming up.
Hit it!